And the reason I want to tell this story is because I think that this is the most misunderstood subject of all. It's this incredible archipelago of knowledge which is hidden from most people. And the reason why it is so is because of the way mathematics is taught at school. Most people get their everything they know about math from what they study. And the way mathematics is taught, unfortunately, is akin to teaching an art class in which you would only teach the students how to paint a fence or a wall, but you never show them the paintings of the great masters. There is paint involved, all right, but it's totally different. And don't even tell them that these paintings exist. So of course, years later, you'd have someone say, oh, I hated art at school. I don't understand why I had to do it. If I need to have my fence painted, I'll just hire somebody. And of course, the point is lost, which is that art offers us so much more than just painting a fence. And likewise, when people say, I'm bad at math, I hate math, what they're really saying is, I hate painting a fence. So, but I was in the same position myself. And when I was a kid, I didn't care much for mathematics. I thought it was a boring, lifeless, irrelevant subject. I was interested in quantum physics. But I was lucky. There was someone in my life who was a mathematician, professional mathematician, my last year of high school, who showed me this incredible world of mathematics, opened the doors for me. And so I fell in love with mathematics. And in writing this book, I tried to sort of give back this love back to my readers and do for them what my teachers and my mentors did for me. Which brings me to the second point, why love? I feel that I have been very lucky in my life, that I was a beneficiary of love. A beneficiary of love of my parents and also of my teachers and mentors. And I talk about this a lot in my book, and I think it's very important to realize when I look back on my career in mathematics, it's incredible how many people helped me along the way. And all of them, their generosity, you know, they did it just to help me. There was no benefit for them. They just helped me. And when I look back, it's incredible. My good friend Alex Friedland, who's unfortunately out of the country right now, he made this comment which I thought was very interesting. After he read this book, he said, it's funny, he said, it takes a village. So in a way, it's sort of a trite, you know, sentiment, but it's true. I had, if you count, there is really a number of people, great mathematicians, some of them, who just really gave me a lot of help and a lot of love. So I was a beneficiary of that love. And actually, also, not only mathematicians, because today in this audience, Thomas Farber, my very good friend and co-author, and my mentor in writing. Writing is very difficult, something I didn't realize. And so in my book, I talk about my teachers and mentors who helped me, who guided me into the world of mathematics. And Tom was the one who guided me into the world of writing. So, and I'm very happy to have him here with us at this launch party for this book.